Hey, can you take me back to when you were let go by the Sixers and what was going on during that particular time in your life, and just talk about the way you played in the bubble and how that led to you getting into the contract with the Mavs?
Yeah, I think that was March of this year, actually. Seemed like so much happened since then. Seemed like it was a year before, but it was actually this year. Like you said, I got released from the Sixers, and at the time, there was a lot of uncertainty. I didn't know what was next. I had interest, small interest from other teams, but I wasn't playing much in Philly at the time, so I didn't really have much value at the time. It was right before the pandemic had hit, and I just pretty much got to work. I stayed in Jersey, actually, during the time when I was let go, and I had a personal trainer out there. His name is Johnny Clark. He was out there working out with me. We would work out 2 or 3 times a day, and I would kind of still treat every day like it was a practice day, like as if I was still on the team, because I still believed that I belonged in the league and could produce at a high level. So I just stayed prepared, and Dallas came at the right time, right before the pandemic, and right before the bubble. And you know, one thing led to another. Everyone knows about the Corona situation. You know, me coming down with Corona, and you know, getting through that, and you know, getting to Orlando and helping the team produce. And now, you know, landing a 3-year contract. So, like I said before, I just thank Mark and Coach Carlisle and God himself, my family members, my wife, my mother and father, all my support system. It's been my journey is inspiring to, you know, a lot of players coming into the league, even players that come into the league with a lot of high expectations. You know, I don't think I lived up to my expectations at first, and I think now I'm getting to a point in my career where I am starting to find who I am as a player and where I can be, you know, most effective at.
All right, Mark Falwell. Mark?
Trey, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Mark.
Yes, one of the things we talked about on the TV broadcast is that it seems like in the preseason games that you and Jalen Brunson are developing a nice chemistry together, and they back up back forward. You guys really seem to have games that complement one another. Are we seeing that accurately? Do you feel like that's the case so far?
Definitely. I think me and Jalen are a great 1-2 punch when we're on the court. We know each other's spots. We didn't get to play with each other a lot last year in the bubble. Obviously, he was out. But the year before that, I spent a little bit of time, as you know, here in Dallas. And I was able to share the court with him then. I think, you know, with our skill sets, we complement each other. You know, his ability to be able to penetrate, get to the free throw line. He's very fundamentally sound, knows how to make the right play. My ability to, you know, put pressure on the ball on the defensive end and break down the defense, I think, you know, we're just going to have to be aggressive when we're out there, and, you know, we can make a lot of good things happen.
Okay, Brad Townsend. Brad?
Trey, you've been on some pretty good teams. We're on a playoff team in Washington, and a good team in Philly last year. You were in the bubble with the Mavs last year. I'm wondering, what is the vibe on this team in terms of opportunity and expectation?
Well, it's, you know, always easy to say expectations is a championship, but that is our goal. We believe it. We believe that we have the talent here to compete for a championship. I think we have a lot of short-term goals that we want to accomplish before, you know, we can look towards a championship, and I think that starts tomorrow. You know, we have a good test tomorrow in Phoenix, you know, against a really good team who went undefeated in the bubble, you know, with a great addition, you know, Chris Paul. So, chemistry-wise, man, this is one of the, you know, best teams I've been on, you know, this early. As well as we've meshed, you know, it's crazy. So I think the sky is the limit for this team. Where will it go? I don't know. But it looks good. It looks really good. And tomorrow, I think we're all excited to get out there for our first game and see what we do.
Okay, a few more. Dorothy? Dorothy Gentry, go ahead.
Yep.
Hi, Dorothy.
Can you tell a little bit about how your faith guides how you prepare for a game?
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
How your faith prepares you for a game or helps you prepare for a game? And how it dictates what you do on and off the court?
Yeah, I think it starts every day. It helps your day. You know, when you start your day right with God Himself, I'm a believer. So I know it's more than just basketball. I'm more than a basketball player. So I try to start my day the right way before I come to the court, and it helps me. It helps me mentally. It helps me physically. It helps me emotionally. Prayer and spending time with my kids before I come here. You know, I think sometimes fans forget we humans as well, and we share the same emotions as other people who work regular jobs. So we have to stay spiritually grounded and mentally grounded as well. And there's a lot of things that I do on a daily basis to keep me there.
Callie Kaplan.
Hey, Trey. You mentioned the addition of Chris Paul for the Suns earlier, but what kind of challenges do the Suns' new guards face, Devin Booker and Chris Paul, especially with you coming in and having this kind of defensive expectation?
A great challenge. You know, they're very aggressive. Two very aggressive guards who oppose their will, you know, in defenses. Devin Booker is a great, great player, great young player who has a green light and is able to get hot at any given moment. Chris Paul, who's a Hall of Fame point guard, you know, is a guy who's experienced. You know, we're gonna have to be locked in and ready, but I know we are.
Okay, one last question from Tamara from Mavs Community, our department.
Hey, Trey. Right now in Columbus, there's 20 special kids that are coming to their doors to receive Christmas presents. Why was it important to you and your wife to bless these kids this year? Can you give a little bit of background on who they are?
I'm sorry.
Can you repeat?
Can you hear any of it, or no?
Can you repeat that, Tamara, please?
Okay, so right now there's 20 kids in Columbus that are getting gifts from you and your wife. Can you share more on who these kids are and why you wanted to bless them this year?
Yes, we wanted to just bless 20 random kids in the city of Columbus, 20 kids who usually wouldn't get the opportunity to get blessed by an NBA player. I'm from Columbus, Ohio. I want to give back to my community. Obviously, during the holiday seasons, we have opportunity to use our platform in the right way. And that was something out of my heart that I wanted to do for less fortunate kids. We have other ideas in mind going forward, but with us traveling and doing so much on the road right now, me not being able to physically be there, I still wanted to have a part of my appreciation to my community and show my appreciation in that way.
All right, thanks a lot, Trey. Appreciate the time.